My name's Jenna Koloski, and I'm the Community and Policy Manager with the Vermont Council on Rural Development. And for our next accelerator speech this morning, I have the pleasure of introducing not only a Vermont climate economy catalyst and leader, but also a nationally recognized energy visionary. Since 2008, Mary Powell has led Vermont's largest utility company towards an ambitious energy vision to provide low carbon, low cost, and reliable power to Vermonters. The 2014 Power Gen Woman of the Year, 2015 Vermonter of the Year, and last year, Mary was named one of Fast Company's top 100 most creative people in business today. Here in Vermont, we're extremely lucky to have a long list of assets and resources that build momentum towards a low-carbon climate economy future. And right at the top of that list is the innovative, creative, and driven leadership at the helm of our largest utility. So please join me in welcoming Green Mountain Power CEO, Mary Powell.
All right. It's really nice to be here. Thanks for that wonderful introduction. I personally love the Power Gen Woman of the Year. It just somehow sounds like I'm a Powder Puff girl or something. I don't know. Anyway, it's wonderful to be here. I feel like this structure is a great place to be doing what we need to be doing in Vermont, which is kind of a barn raising around the climate economy. So thank you, Paul, so much. And the organization for pulling together this amazing event to hear so many wonderful minds, great minds, talk about what is going on in the country and what we can do in Vermont. And that is, it's interesting, and I can't wait to follow up with Jigar, because we're going to get that $500 million he was talking about, so got to figure that out. But one of the things I love, and I really want to emphasize about Vermont, is really something we heard this morning, which is, I think our strongest asset, and actually back to Jigar's offer, our strongest asset is we actually can get together, we can collaborate, and we can pull off amazing stuff that other states and communities only dream of, because we can really leverage our small size as a state to work together towards these kinds of goals versus operating in silos. So I feel like everything I talk about and everything Green Mountain Power has been able to do, it's not about Green Mountain Power, actually. It's about that Green Mountain Power has been smart enough to tap into all of the incredible talent and energy and enthusiasm we have in this beautiful little state around transformation. So that is again what excites me about the future. I really believe that we can pull off tremendous change, and we have. And so, you know, back in 2008 at Green Mountain Power, our portfolio was about 16% renewable. As of right now, as of January 1st of 2018, we're going to be over 60% renewable and 90% carbon-free in our portfolio. And that really is attributed to, we worked with, again, many stakeholders. We collaborated across the state to launch a very ambitious energy vision back in 2008, it was ambitious, but it was necessary. It was necessary because it was created because we are an organization that is obsessed with our customers. We're obsessed with the Vermonters we served. We're not just obsessed with them in the context of delivering what they say they want, which is pretty much low cost, low carbon, incredibly reliable power, but we're also obsessed with their values. We're obsessed with how they think about energy. We talk to them relentlessly. We survey them. We poll them. We get every bit of data we can, and we're obsessed with them. And so our energy vision started, which seemed ambitious at the time, which was around how do we move into the future providing a portfolio that is as low carbon, low cost, and incredibly reliable as possible. And a huge part of what Vermonters also said they wanted was local renewable energy. And that was also a big part of our energy vision, which was developing cost-effective local renewable energy resources. And not just one of the projects that got a lot of attention was building Vermont's largest wind farm, which we did on behalf of the Vermonters we serve, which I have to say is one of the most cost-effective resources in our portfolio for them. But it also was about partnering with the amazing solar community we have in Vermont and talking about how we could leverage the development of an economy around renewable energy in Vermont and really accelerate that. And so those were huge parts of how we got to where we are today. Where we're looking towards in the future and the sort of Energy Vision 2.0 that we launched a couple of years ago is really about, again, taking these Vermont values and going deeper and further in the context of energy transformation. And it's, you know, it's neat as I'm sitting here listening, Dan, to your presentation, which was incredibly thoughtful, and some of the others. You know, I think one of the strategic advantages we have in Vermont is actually, I believe, that we can accelerate which a consumer-led revolution to a home, business, and community-based energy system. And so while I think some of these massive solutions are needed in different parts of the country, what my hope and dream, based on the obsession of our customers in Vermont, is actually Vermont can continue to be an outlier, and we can actually develop, candidly, the much more reliable, cost-effective, environmentally sustainable solution of the future, which is really to move to a community, home, and business-based energy system. The bulk system that we have today, and actually, if in looking at that presentation, you see one thing, which is it's going to get a lot costlier. The bulk system that we have that delivers energy to us today is about, on a good day, 40% economically efficient. 40% economically efficient. And actually, if you look at the presentation we just saw, what you will say is, yeah, and actually, it's probably going to become economically a lot less efficient. Because we had last year, the United States of America spent the most it's ever spent on transmission, which gets socialized across all of us, which was over $10 billion. And we're actually headed in a direction to have that same kind of spending in future years. While nothing really has fundamentally changed about grandma's electric system, and it's not grandma's fault. It's just been around a long time, and it wasn't built for economic efficiency. So the work that we are excited about, that we've been able to collaborate with amazing Vermont companies on, is how do we deliver on this community, home, and business-based energy system model? You know, how do we work with Vermonters to do what, actually, again, we're obsessed with Vermonters, we're obsessed with their values. Vermonters, we love local food. We like local music. We like local energy. So we really believe that by tapping into that and tapping into what is happening nationally, which is there is a move away from bulk delivery system solutions and to distributed energy solutions, it's happening not just in states like Vermont, not just with consumers that are interested in having a solar panel or a Tesla Powerwall. It's happening all over the country. It's actually happening, I think some of it's getting accelerated in a reaction to some of what's happening nationally. And we're seeing big stores like Walmart with objectives to become much more energy self-sufficient. We see more and more commercial customers all over the country, you know, moving in the direction of energy independence. So we really believe that what we can do and what we have with this incredible smart technology that we have in the Vermont system is lead the way and potentially defer literally tens and tens of millions of dollars of regional cost by developing a much more home, community, and business-based energy system. And so that is a lot of the work we're doing. A lot of the work we're doing is working on the ground with customers, doing transformative type of energy solutions, like I see Ludi Biddle here and others that I've had the privilege to work with on working on bringing wraparound services to Vermonters, where we're delivering efficiency, weatherization, solar, all of the new smart technology solutions so that Vermonters can deliver these solutions for themselves and have a lower cost, more comfortable, low carbon experience. So, and again, along those lines, we We were the first to partner with Tesla. We partner with lots of storage solutions, not just Tesla, but we're doing it in the context of how can we increase the comfort, the reliability, the cost effectiveness of your home or your business, but how can we also do that in ways that help us transform the cost of the grid as we move to the future. So we're very excited about the work that we've gotten to do so far, but we are much, much more excited about what lies ahead of us. I believe it is an incredible opportunity from an economic perspective for Vermont. Just the work we alone have done at Green Mountain Power has spawned over a dozen other businesses in Vermont. So we really believe this will give Vermont an incredible competitive advantage. And most important, this work has been done in the context of we were able to lower bills 3 times over the last 4 years, and we are doing all of this work in the context of how to be incredibly cost effective for Vermonters. And so with that, I think I'll just wrap with a quick little video that I like because it catches all the things that I missed. So thank you. I think we will. Okay. Hey, Mike.
And the town lit up. The world got still. I'm learning to fly. But I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. Well, the good old days may not return. Rocks might melt, and the seed may burn. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. You down and break your heart, steal your crown. So I started out for God knows where. I guess I'll know when I get there.
With that, that's it.